Hey guys, Shadefire here, and welcome to level 2 of Let's Play Jurassic Park Trespasser. This is the Jungle Road. Our objective in this level is just to continue following the monorail, which is much sparser in this part than it was in that first area.
8 left.
Now we've got a raptor hiding over there. We're just gonna grab our Desert Eagle from the gun box and leave him to his business. Here we've got another one of these silly seesaws they like to show off, but...
An idea brought me awake one morning in New York. I almost didn't write it down.
It's not particularly functional, so... We're just gonna keep going. Now this level's a lot bigger than the previous level. And all the levels after this as well will be large.
What if a mosquito sucked the blood of a dinosaur? 100 million years ago. The insect is then covered in tree sap, which, over the millennia, becomes amber.
Those gun boxes you see everywhere are another one of those things that make sense from a gameplay perspective, but don't make much sense from a design perspective for the actual island.
The insect is preserved perfectly. But you see, and here's the clever part, wouldn't the dinosaur blood be preserved as well?
Here we've got our second non-hostile dinosaur, the Stegosaurus. You can see he just kind of glances around at us. You might have noticed that a lot of the dinosaurs move really weirdly, especially the raptors when they jump. This is because this game doesn't use the traditional system of modeling animations based on a skeleton and then playing them in the appropriate moments. Instead, they programmed algorithms of inverse kinematics, which is normally what robots use to understand how to move.
DNA? A tiny spiral of genetic code. Abracadabra.
It's another one of those ideas they used that was interesting, but ultimately poorly executed, because dinosaurs look pretty silly sometimes. Let's see if I can just... Nope.
5.
Almost shot myself there. Which is perfectly possible in this game if you happen to be pointing the gun at yourself.
4. 3, 2, 1.
You might have noticed that the raptors don't actually bite you per se, so much as jam their face against you. The reason for this is because the way damage works for raptors is they have a little strip in their mouth that you take damage from if you
Sunlight
touch
angled
it.
Down through the dusty air in Norman's office, and I leaned against a solid oak table as I outline my plans for international genetic technologies.
So because of this, you can actually get killed by a dead raptor if you step on its head too much. Oh, yeah. Another one of these ledges I got caught on. And of course, another one of those puzzles where they just put a box on top of... Oh, I almost forgot about this. This here is the Ruger Redhawk.
6 rounds.
It's more powerful than either the Desert Eagle or the Smith & Wesson 686. But it only has 6 shots. It's also a bit more accurate. I find it a lot easier to shoot because of the longer barrel.
7 shots.
Here we've got a little valley that we're going to stop off on before continuing on over there. Because there is a vehicle over there.
It was the flowering of an ambition born 50 years ago. 50 years struggle come to this.
Now this right here is one of the... Lost World references. This movie chronologically takes place after the Lost World, which is why this stuff is here.
Six left.
Engine standard safari vehicle. State of the art. The hunters scattered, their prearranged hunting routes forgotten. Only a third of their number appeared at the rendezvous.
Now, of course, we got our Browning High Power rifle here, which, there was actually one in the first level, but I missed it. It's got 10 shots, and it's pretty accurate. It's one of the better guns in the game.
Oh, that's not good.
But instead, we're gonna take this.
That's not good. I'm not gonna make it back from here, am I?
6 rounds.
Now we're just going to head back up to that little path that we were on earlier. Now, the reason I took the skull is because, for some odd reason, it actually makes a very effective melee weapon. One of the few objects in the game that does. I don't know if this is because they added a bunch of mass to it or something, but a couple good hits will take down a raptor. That said, it's still a melee weapon, and therefore not a very effective weapon in general.
Ow! 6 rounds. 5.
Guns are still much more effective. Here we got a hidden sledgehammer. But, just like every other melee weapon, it's not very useful. Good for throwing, I guess.
5 shots.
Since I don't really want to waste my ammo just to break that door down.
8 left.
I'm gonna use this crappy Desert Eagle. Well, I guess it's not crappy since we haven't used it yet.
7. 6.
But, grab this shotgun.
7 shots.
So here's the Benelli M1 Super 90. It's a little bit better, I'd say, than the SPAS because it's more accurate. Though they both do the same amount of damage. I don't quite know how Anne manages to fire a shotgun by holding it in the center and not, you know, ever pumping it. But just one of the many mysteries of Trespasser, I guess. I do find that because of the way she holds it, it's actually really hard to aim the shotguns, though. So you really kind of want to jam it up against Raptor before you fire it.
5 shots.
You can see some of the areas this monorail is nothing more than a single block telling you you're going the right way. But I think it's an interesting idea using a common theme in the environment to lead you. A lot like the Cold Stream campaign for Left 4 Dead, except that campaign also turned out to be terrible. And here we got a pair of raptors trying to take down a triceratops. There's no real guaranteed victor in this fight. The triceratops can take the raptors down in about one hit. But he's got a really slow turn radius, or she rather, since all the dinosaurs on Jurassic Park are female. So the Triceratops does tend to win, but it's not impossible to be taken down by the Velociraptors, and looks like they both got sat on, so Triceratops is victorious again. Now to continue on with the level, we want to head that way, but first we're going to dip into this valley over here. Of course, bunny hopping is always faster than walking. Now, originally this level had 2 ways to complete it, which is why it splits off at this point. However, they decided to cut the other way, so they wouldn't have to finish it, and so there's just some of the leftover areas over here, but no way to continue. Here we got another friendly dinosaur, the Parasaurolophus. He's not even a lot of these in the game, but it's a neat thing to see. You can see his crazy stretchy legs. Now, from a gameplay perspective, it might seem a little weird to have friendly dinosaurs around. But originally, all the dinosaurs were programmed with a number of emotions and needs. The problem with this is that, while they were working on it, dinosaurs would basically have constant mood swings where they would switch moods so quickly they would be stuck in place. Now to fix this in time for release, the developers decided just to max out hunger and aggression for all the raptors and lock them at that so that they would always be going for you. Originally, they would attack other dinosaurs like this and then eat them.
7 shots.
And if we follow this para, who's oddly going down to this valley, we find another Lost World reference. That's, of course, the scene at the beginning of Lost World, where a little girl gets attacked by compies. Heading back up here, there's actually a Spanish plantation house we'll be seeing up on the right. But I am going to meet you there, because it's a bit of a trek. Here it is, the old Spanish plantation house, and a raptor spooking around. There we go. This, of course, would have been here long before InGen built Site B. There's not too much left of it. However, there are a few interesting things inside. Let's see what they got, what's left of the stable back here.
Looks like seven.
Just a bunch of empty rooms, mostly. Over here, we've still got a map of the Cinque Morte, the five deaths. Two of which are the islands that the two Jurassic Parks are located on, Isla Sorna and Isla Nublar. I don't quite remember what the other three are. I think one of them is Isla Manticoros, and I can't remember the other two. Each one's supposed to represent
like
a different horrible way of dying. So before we head out here, there's actually a gun hidden around in this house for some reason. Doesn't really make sense of it being here, since obviously the Spanish wouldn't have had automatic machine guns in their house. But if we pull open this here, we find an old gold ingot. Not much good to us right now. And exceptionally heavy. And
feels full.
Calico MP50. The MP50 is a pretty terrible weapon.
Four shots.
But
hasn't been used.
It carries about 100 rounds in it, so the low damage doesn't really matter too much. Now, if we head back that way, towards the beach, and then swing around to the right, you'll actually find two spotted shotguns on the ground, and then a slope where the level used to be split into two.
Four bullets.
However, we're going to be seeing that in the Easter eggs, if I can get it to work, with the teleport command, since you can actually still travel through it to the monorail at the end of the level. One of the main reasons in this game to explore is the sound clips. Since most of them are triggered to specific locations, so they give you a little bit of a reason to explore. There's also usually some guns and stuff around, but those aren't too necessary.
I rode south along the coast, bus stationed in the early morning, eating vending machine food in the fluorescent light, stepping out of the bus in Mexico City. I shouldered my knapsack, felt the heat wash over me. It was good to be alone. Be nobody for a while.
And here we found the rest of the monorail proper, as well as a phone. Let's see if we can't call us up some help.
A phone, oh thank God.
Of course not. That'd be too easy. So we got another box piling puzzle here. We're gonna try to do it the developer's way, which is to pitch a rock at it. That didn't work too well. That rock was too heavy. Let's try a lighter rock. Got lucky this time.
Four shots.
So, if we can just throw our gun up there so it doesn't bounce. Well, it's gonna roll right off.
Four bullets.
Might be easier to actually just hop up here and let go of it. Just ram that box into place.
Four bullets.
Hop on the monorail. Now, for the rest of the level, we can pretty much just follow the monorail. Or no, wait, that's not right. Forgot, there's another valley between us and the rest of the monorail. And another new gun here. Oh, no, wait. I am getting my valleys mixed up. Okay, so there's another Ruger here. I'll just take
six
that.
Six rounds.
Another sneaky raptor.
Five.
Tri-bay raptors aren't too much of a challenge if you've got decent aim and enough distance between you to actually aim at them. However, they're not the only raptors in the game. It looks like this poor fellow has gotten stuck in himself. As you can see. This is one of the reasons they remove jumping, because it will cause this raptor compression, though there are other ways it happens too. Oh shit. Should probably actually shoot him before getting killed.
One.
You're a tough little bugger, aren't you?
Feels full.
However, we should be able to unstick him with a light touch. Well, it usually works, but I guess he's compressed forever. The zip file of raptors. And in case you weren't accustomed to it already, here's yet another box too high up,
six
gotta
left.
Get it down puzzle. Though this one also happens to have a gun on top, so I'm gonna try to get that gun and the box down.
Full clip.
Now, we could switch out the Calico here for this silenced MP5K. However, the MP5 is even worse than the Calico. And the silenced version of it does less damage than the non-silenced version, and has shorter range. So we're just going to throw that away, because it's junk.
Full clip.
With all this box shoving, Anne looks like she'd actually make a pretty good dock worker. Especially with the right arm strength she's got going on. Another floating gun box here. You might see quite a few things in the game that are floating like this. The reason for this is because of the way they made the map. What they did, essentially, they made all the terrain first, and then dropped objects in at certain elevations. However, some of them, of course, are not matched up perfectly.
Five rounds left.
So they're floating. Here we've got yet another SMG-type weapon, the VP-70. The H&K VP-70. The VP-70 is kind of okay, but you've only got about 7 bursts in it before it's empty. Doesn't do a lot of damage either.
A lost world is a sort of scientific myth. An evolutionary scenario in which an ecosystem is isolated and preserved. The rest of the world changes, leaving a tiny, fragile pocket where ancient species survive.
Now that little
yadda yadda yadda.
That theoretical lost world that he talks about gets discussed a lot in the second Jurassic Park book. And makes sense considering the name. Another big old brachiosaur here. Brachiosaurs are a bit of a pain in the ass to have around when you have raptors around, because as we saw earlier, they shake the crap out of your screen, making it hard to aim. As far as I know, brachiosaurs are unkillable by other dinosaurs or by yourself. Because I've tried unloading a couple guns on them before to no effect. And they won't attack you either. They're pretty much just big walking set pieces. Now, before we climb up on the monorail here, there should be...
In the winter, we began building supports for the elevated transit system that would unify the island. Concrete towers rose through the jungle canopy.
Almost gone.
And it's already empty. Great.
Full clip. Almost gone. Empty.
No good.
Here. Extract guns, by the way, Swedish made, unbeatable for accuracy and rate of fire.
Now, the Lindstrat is one of the only two guns in the game that are fictional guns. It's a tranquilizer pistol, which has a bit of a weird effect in-game.
10 shots.
Here we've got the Barrett M82 50 cal sniper rifle. Call of Duty's players might recognize this. This thing is pretty much impossible to aim. The reason for that is because it's mounted onto this bipod, and you can't remove it, so you just kind of have to rotate it around and... Oh, jeez. Hope the dinosaur doesn't kill you first. It's not very great, but to make up for it, it is pretty much a one-shot kill on any enemy. Come on.
9 shots.
Now this is just silly.
6 rounds.
However, we don't actually have a gun to kill them. So what I'm going to try to do is hit them with the tranquilizer, which you can see will just turn them into a statue temporarily. And then, well, he's stuck like that.
5 rounds left.
With them out of the way, we can climb up on the monorail again. This segment is probably one of the most annoying in this level. The main reason for that is because they expect you to jump between pieces of monorail track, and often get snagged on the edge when you jump across, causing you to fall off and die. It's a good idea to make some saves when you're doing this part.
Curving up out of the southern basin, the Atherton Causeway would bring visiting scientists north from the southern beach.
Well, they certainly were serious about their monorail.
I don't know why Anne sounds so derisive about the monorail there. Considering it's how she knows where she's going. Ah, and there we go. Oh, actually survived that fall. Didn't even take that much damage. You don't actually have to stay on the monorail for this part to get to the end. It's just easier to avoid dinosaurs if you do. But, of course, if you fall off here, you can just climb up there.
5 rounds left.
If we hadn't, we would actually cause this part to fall.
5 shots.
Preventing us from having to take fall damage to get down. However, this part, if we fall, we'll absolutely die. So you want to just take it straight away and jump. It's honestly usually a better idea to hit the jump key a couple times, so that when you land on the other side, you'll jump again. Instead of slipping off. And down there, we've got another raptor. Can actually kind of trap him here by dropping this girder on his head. That's kind of hard to do, though. Unless he plays ball. Come on. Yeah, that's right. Tasty morsel up here. Oh. Not only did I not kill him, but I almost fell off. Come on, raptor. Ah, so close.
5 shots. 4.
Hit him with that, and then hop across to here, where we get another high power.
10 shots.
I don't know why this shack is labeled fragile.
9.
It's clearly not that fragile. It didn't collapse when we landed on it.
4 shots.
Forgot to point out earlier that all these in-gen boxes are labeled fragile as well. This is actually the most common object in the game.
It's 9. 4 shots. 3.
Now, for the most part, the tranquilizer isn't that useful because it's usually better just to have a gun. But there are certain ways that it makes things easier. If you don't have anything else available, it's definitely worth taking with you.
3 left.
Got some options for guns here.
8 left.
I think I'm going to drop the hunting rifle. Grab another
like
one of the M1s. Keep my lens trap for now, because it'll actually come in handy. We're getting pretty close to the end now. Just got a lot more of this monorail hopping to do before we get there. The end is just around that bend up ahead. Carefully went my way across. Any of the floating objects in the game that have physics attached to them will usually drop to the ground once you touch them. We'll be seeing this a lot more in level 4, the town. Now this part right here is kind of difficult. They expect you to make this jump, but it's a pretty difficult jump to make. It's usually easier to just try to hit those boxes down there and survive the fall. Which I didn't. Alright, so let's try that again. Alright, now let's try this jump the way they wanted us to do it, which is just to get a good running start. Whew.
Looks like 7.
Turning this into a ramp. The ramp didn't drop the way I expected it to. So we'll just deal with this guy.
Only
seems to be off on business on his own.
1.
Alright then, if he doesn't want to fight, we'll just continue. And they throw one last jumping puzzle on you. If you fall between these, you're pretty much screwed because the fall to get down and retry this will probably kill you. And that's the end of level 2 of Let's Play Jurassic Park Trespasser. I've been Shadefire, and I hope you'll join me next time for level 3, the Industrial Jungle, or the Industrial Road. One of the two. First Easter egg of this level is the M1911, which was originally going to be in the game, but was cut during development. For some reason, it appears in this level in the area known as the basement, this weird place where a bunch of random objects are underneath the level. And we can't reach it from down here, but if we pull up fly... float on up. And there it is. It doesn't actually have any firing sounds or damage or anything like that attached to it. All that's there is the model.
It's like hiking in the woods behind my house. We used to pretend we were on a spy mission.
That right there was one of 2 misplaced voice clips in this level. Just kind of floating off here, off of the main level. There's also another one. That's actually from the first level. Coordinates 2614, 368, 11.
A southern beach looked out over trackless ocean, down past Peru all the way to Antarctica.
Just one of the many things the developers kind of left laying around in the level, out of reach of the player. The last one is the one I mentioned earlier in the video. The Hidden Valley. Originally, following this path down here would lead to these 2 shotguns and this overturned truck, and then back here to this Triceratops, which is the only thing marking where the valley used to be, this wall back here. Going over here, you can see where the actual path would have been. You would have followed this all the way, and this goes right past the fight with the Triceratops, the little waterfall, and then the monorail. You can see they pretty much didn't even put foliage in here yet. and there's no sound clips or anything left. But coming out just over this ridge would bring you out by the start of the monorail. And, yeah, that's pretty much it. There's a tooltip somewhere in the game that mentions this, but other than that, this is the only remains of the Hidden Valley area. And that's about it for level 2.